Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 14 has been out for a little bit over a week now. I've been using it on my iPhone 11 Pro Max, and also the iPhone 7 here has it installed as well. This is a jet black iPhone 7 that they released a while ago, and I really like this finish, but it's not as nice as the matte finish as far as keeping away those fingerprints. But I wanted to talk about whether or not you should install iOS 14 betas, and also answer the question of when is iOS 14 public beta 1 going to come out? What is the beta schedule going to look like? And also when you can expect the final public release of iOS 14. I get asked that almost daily, those questions. And so I wanted to compare it with iOS 13 and then help you decide whether or not you should install iOS 14 betas based on feedback I've had, previous experience with every single iOS and iPhone OS beta, and then also show you how it compares to a public release such as iOS 13.6 when it comes to performance on older devices. So the first thing is iOS 14 should be released to public beta testers not too long from now. In fact, if we take a look at the calendar here, I would expect iOS 14 public beta 1 on either the 6th or the 7th of July. And that's based on what they did last year, releasing it 2 weeks later. So when iOS 13 was released, 2 weeks later, the public beta came out. And then every couple of weeks, there was a new beta. And so, for example, on June 4th, Apple released iOS 13 beta 1. Then on June 17th, they released public beta 1 with beta 2 of the developer beta. Then on July 2nd, they released beta 3. And then they again released it on July 8th, along with the second build of beta 3 and also iOS 13 public beta 2. It was really confusing. Then they went to July 17th and then continued on a week by week schedule. So what you can expect is currently expect a couple weeks where we'll have, or a couple maybe into end of the end of July or so, where we'll have a new beta every couple of weeks. And then we'll also have it speed up as we get closer to September, where we'll have a new beta every week. And so I'm not sure the exact number of betas that we'll see, but expect every couple of weeks to have a new one, with the public beta 1 starting not too far from now, if Apple continues to do what they've done in the past. Then we'll see a final release towards the end of September, or maybe in October this year, since things got pushed a little bit further back. So last year, September 29th, 2019, Apple released iOS 13 to the public, and then maybe we'll see iOS 14 then, but I would say it's probably more likely to be in October based on things being pushed back a few weeks this year. Now, when it does come out, I wanted to help you decide if you should install it or not. And so the good thing about betas, though, is that you can roll back to previous versions. But before you do any of that, make sure you have a backup on your phone, either iCloud backup or iTunes or the Finder on your Mac. Make sure you have a physical backup somewhere in case you want to restore to a previous version. Also, in order to restore, you'll need a computer. So just keep that in mind. So I wouldn't suggest putting the beta on, or at least early betas, on your main device. I would use an older device, such as an iPhone 7 maybe you have laying around, maybe a device that you were going to get rid of, or maybe you just have a device that you have as a secondary device. Put it on the one you're not using the most, and you'll probably find that that's a better way to do that based on the first few betas. Now, later on, it could be much more stable. In fact, iOS 14 has been more stable in general than any iOS 13 or even early 12 betas. So that's a good sign, but there are some bugs with it. So let me talk about some of those bugs, and then we'll talk about speed and things on older devices in a moment. Now, one bug that I continually have that really is driving me nuts, but it's a beta, so it's not too big of a deal, is when I go to airdrop a photo. So maybe I want to airdrop this wallpaper to, say, that iPhone 7 so they can match for this video. If I go into photos, then I go to airdrop that photo. I've already got it selected, and maybe I want to airdrop it over to that iPhone 6S Plus. A lot of the time it will fail, and of course it's going to work now, but in order to get it to work properly, I actually have to hard reboot the phone. So maybe I want to send it to the Mac, for example. It might send, it may not, and this time it's going to send. So it's really hit or miss for me, and I've had to reboot the phone about 3 times to get AirDrop to work properly. It works fine on previous builds for me. I've also had a few issues with some apps. There's a couple that won't work, and one that I keep hearing a lot is Pokemon Go. So if you play Pokemon Go, you do not want to install this update in this version unless you are waiting for them to update it, or maybe beta 2 will work better. But right now, Pokemon Go doesn't seem to work with iOS 14. So there's certain things that may not be acceptable for you. And if your apps don't work, then you shouldn't be using this because you need to rely on it. So just keep in mind that there's going to be issues. Also, battery life could go to great, or it could go really poor. Apple does not focus so much on battery life during betas. They try and get those sorts of things sorted before the public release. So they're focusing on getting their code right, getting things operating properly. And for example, this is my iPhone 11 Pro Max. I have 97% battery capacity. And if we go to the last 10 days, we'll just take a look at today. You'll see I have 3 hours and 16 minutes of screen on time and 2 hours and 46 minutes of screen off time. Now, you'll see that I've used about 39% of my battery here. So you can see we're at 61% currently. So I've used 39% of my battery and I only have a few hours. So this is not really good compared to what I got before. Previously, I would get about 12 hours of screen on time. So that's not too much of an issue for me. I can just plug it in where I am. It's not an issue, but it may be an issue for a lot of people. Now, based on the feedback app, Apple will continue to work on the problems based on priority. So if you report feedback, they'll work on it based on the importance of what's going on. So for example, maybe music isn't working properly, or maybe you open the camera and it crashes every time and you report that. That's going to be a higher priority on the list than, say, battery life this early on, because, well, it's important that major functions work, such as the camera. Batteries can be worked on a little bit later, and you can always plug it in. So just keep those things in mind when you're testing a beta. Now, on older devices such as the iPhone 7, performance seems to be okay. However, expect it not to be as good as the iPhone 11 Pro Max, because with the 11 Pro Max, I've actually had some locking up. From time to time, it will sort of freeze. I've also had keyboard entry or typing entries be a little bit slow from time to time. So if I go into notes and maybe I type a new note saying this is a new note, and you'll see that's fine, but sometimes it will just sort of hang. So keep that in mind. But compared to, say, iOS 13.6 on this iPhone 6S Plus, well, scrolling, your normal tasks and everything seem to be nice and fast. So scrolling through different menus and everything else seem to be about the same. I really don't see any performance hit there. But being that it is a beta, it's going to have some issues. And the longer you use it without restarting it and things in early betas, it tends to have more issues. So just keep that in mind. Usually Apple will release the public betas when they feel they're ready enough for the majority of people to use them without major issues. So I would say it's usually safe with a public beta to install it, but just be cautious and know that if you need to go back, you'll need a computer to do that, and you need to have a backup to restore from, or you'll have to start over. So as far as iOS 14, I look really forward to following betas. Of course, I'll have videos on those as soon as they come out, but hopefully this helps you decide whether or not you should install one and gives you an idea of what to expect as far as release schedules going forward. Let me know if you've installed iOS 14 in the comments below, or if you plan to install the beta as soon as it comes out for public beta testers. I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description as I always do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.